This video is going to be about multiplying polynomials. So let's start out with a monomial times a monomial. Here we have the monomial 2x to the third y squared, and we're multiplying that by 4xy to the fifth. Now when you do this, all you're going to do is multiply the coefficients by the coefficients, in other words, the 2 times the 4, and then take each of the variables separately. In other words, take the x's and multiply them together, take the y's and multiply them together. So here we go. 2 times 4 is going to give me 8. X to the third times x, remember, an x is the same as an x to the first, and when we multiply x to the third times x to the first, we're just going to add their exponents. So 3 plus 1 is 4, so this is going to give me x to the fourth. We go into the y's. We have y squared times y to the fifth. So once again, we're adding the exponents. 2 plus 5 is 7, so I get y to the seventh. And that's all there is to it. Okay, the next step up from multiplying a monomial by a monomial would be multiplying a monomial times a polynomial. And this is really no harder. It's a bit more work, but it's no harder. All we're going to do is take this monomial, negative 3a squared, and distribute it to each of the terms in the polynomial. So first we're going to multiply negative 3a squared times 5a to the third b. So negative 3 times 5 is going to give me a negative 15. Then I've got a squared times a to the third. So that's going to give me, let's see, the exponents are 2 and 3. I'll add the 2 and 3 together and get a to the fifth. And just b. Now I've got to multiply negative 3a squared times negative 2a squared. I've got a negative times a negative, so I'll have a positive here. Negative 3 times negative 2 is positive 6. A squared times a squared, I'm just adding the exponents, 2 plus 2 is 4. So I get a to the fourth. And then for the last term in my polynomial, I've got just a b, so I'm multiplying 3a squared times b. Well, that's just going to give me negative 3. The a squared doesn't multiply anything, so it just remains a squared. And the b over here just remains a b. Okay, so this is our final polynomial. Moving up one more step from this is going to be multiplying a binomial by a binomial. Now what we want to do when we do this is multiply the first term in the first binomial times both of the terms in the second binomial. In other words, we're going to distribute this first term to each of the terms in the second binomial, and then we're going to distribute the second term, the 4 in the first binomial, to each of the terms in the second binomial. And there's a fairly orderly way to do this. So what we're going to do is start with this first term times the first term. And that's going to give us 3 times 2 is 6. X times x is going to be x squared. And now we're going to do the first term times the second term of the second binomial. So 3 times negative 5 is negative 15. And since it was 3x, it's going to become negative 15x. Now I want to take the second term over here, the 4, and multiply it by the first term of the second binomial. So I've got 4 times 2x, well, that's just going to be 8x. And then finally, I'm going to multiply the two last terms. So I've got 4 times negative 5 is negative 20. Now looking at this, I see I have a negative 15x and a positive 8x. And since those are like terms, they're both some coefficient times x, I can combine them. So my 6x squared is going to stay the same. Negative 15x plus 8, negative 15 plus 8 will be a negative. It's going to be negative 7. Negative 7x, and the minus 20 stays the same. So that's going to be my answer. Now sometimes this process is called foiling. And foiling is just a kind of an abbreviation, because what we're doing is we're taking the first term times the first term, that's the f, then the outside term times the outside term, that's the o, then the two inside terms, so there's the I for inside, and then the two last terms, so there's the L. So you can, if the idea of foiling helps you remember the order in which you do these, that's fine. Okay, let's do one more of these since they're probably the most complicated. So once again, okay, here we have 2x minus 6y and 4x minus y. So we're going to take the first term times the first term, and that's going to give us an 8x squared. We'll take the two outside terms. So we've got 2x times negative y, so that's going to be a negative 2xy. Let me draw my lines. We'll take the two inside terms, so that's going to be negative 6y times 4x. Negative 6 times 4 is negative 24. And I had an x and a y, so it's negative 24. XY, and then I'm just multiplying my two last terms. That's going to be negative 6y times negative y. So the negative times negative will give me a positive 6, and I had a y times y, so that'll give me y squared. And now once again, I look and I see that I have two terms that are similar, that are like terms. I've got negative 2xy and negative 24xy, so I can combine them. Starting from the beginning, I have 8x squared. Negative 2 and negative 24 will be negative 26xy. And then I've got positive 6y squared, so plus 6y squared. And that's going to be it. Okay, and that's all there is to it. Take care for now.